Let's start with what computer vision is and why computers need vision.
Sure. Computer vision is an area of computer science and, well, let me just start over. In computer vision, we try to teach computers how to see. And that seeing can refer to understanding scenes, reconstructing 3D objects, recognizing objects, avoiding obstacles, helping blind people navigate. And a lot of this makes use of machine learning, and it also makes use of geometry and applied math. There are legends about how it began as a summer project.
Given to someone who's actually now a professor at MIT, Jerry Sussman, and Marvin Minsky said, okay, for this summer project, why don't you solve the computer vision problem? You know, shouldn't take that long. And wrote a little outline of what he was supposed to do, and then that's kind of what the field's been working on for the past 40 or 50 years.
The term computer vision hasn't really appeared in the popular media that much until recently. Part of that is because when something became successful, it got renamed. Like barcode scanning is an instance of computer vision.
Computer vision is also responsible for the yellow first down line that you might see watching football on TV. It helps stabilize videos and create virtual worlds. It helps cameras see faces so they're not blurry. And it's getting better at recognizing what's going on in a video, making whatever it is you're searching for on YouTube a little easier to find. A lot of the videos on this channel have previously touched on a specific example of computer vision, but here I want to zoom out and give you more of an overview of what computer vision is. So the next time you see those two little words, you'll have a deeper understanding of what they are. What's the differences between like human visual systems versus computer visual systems?
From the computer perspective, the image is really just an array of numbers, or if it's color, it would be three arrays of numbers.
By themselves, these pixels don't mean anything to a computer. The computer has to interpret what they are. And in general, there's four approaches for how it does this.
There's a lot of work by the field on object recognition. So given a photo of something, where are all the objects and what are they?
That is very close to solve at the generic level, meaning that it is a tree, not that it is a very specific type of tree. That remains somewhat challenging.
Another direction is physical reconstructions. So if given a photo of something, what's the three-dimensional shape of everything?
If you think of a Google Street View van going down the street, capturing spherical panoramas, that data it captures is still two-dimensional. But when you feed it to algorithms that match features between those images, you can produce these three-dimensional images. Registration, that's sort of like tracking or alignment of models. If you have a self-driving car and you want to track pedestrians, track lane markings.
Or maybe more familiar to your daily life, selfie lenses. And lastly, there's reorganization.
But more broadly, it's known as unsupervised learning. So, for example, with children, how is it that they learn about the world without being told everything?
Traditionally, computer vision models are trained with massive amounts of labeled data.
The goal within unsupervised learning is that you just get the data and somehow reorganize it in a way where you make sense of it.
An example of this sort of approach took me to a Google robotics lab.
For us, just seeing a robot being able to pick up an object, it's very hard to convey that it's actually a very exciting thing for people who are doing research in this field.
The reason why it's exciting is that when you've seen a robot picking something up in a video, that robot has probably been given a very specific set of rules to help it pick up that very specific object. In contrast, these robot arms have learned to pick up all sorts of objects, even ones they've never seen before, and they don't use rules to do this.
We try to use computer vision in a very implicit kind of way. When the robot sees the object, it's not going to try to recognize that it's an apple. All it does is it's going to use that image to grasp We don't tell it exactly what to do with the image. If it had a sponge, it would learn that, you know, you don't get anywhere by just trying to grasp it. You just pinch it and that you can pick it like that.
Over months of training and more than 800,000 attempts, it's now about 80% successful.
So imagine your robot is trying to grasp this. This is success. And this is failure.
Yeah.
And there's really not much difference in between the two.
A lot of people in object recognition have to remind themselves how hard this problem is for computers. And one way to do that is to turn the image upside down and invert the colors. Mathematically, that doesn't really amount to anything. As far as the computer's concerned, you basically did nothing. But it clearly impairs human ability to recognize things.
I still don't quite understand like how a computer actually sees, but I know that at the end of the day, the world has to be converted to numbers and then...
Well, the thing is, the computer vision researchers don't really understand how a computer sees either. It's funny, it's like alchemy in chemistry. It's like the alchemy came first and then chemistry came. And right now we're in the alchemy stage of computer vision, where it works, but we're not sure why. And it's the chemistry stage that I look forward to.
Computer vision is a very good way to learn about the world. If you can parse what's visually around you, you can learn a lot of information about the real world that you wouldn't have access to otherwise.
My kids right now, one's a toddler, one's an infant. When they're older, I hope they take it for granted. I hope they believe that with their futuristic mobile device, if they see some bug or a little crab on the beach, they will just assume that it has always been the case that you can just snap a photo and that system will tell you what it is and everything you could want to know about it.
What I really love is taking pictures and revealing something about the world that you can't see otherwise. One of my favorite really is something we call motion magnification. It's like a microscope, but instead of making things bigger, it makes motions bigger. There are a lot of potential applications. Really, you'd like to measure vital signs of someone in a non-contact way. I guess I kind of believe in magic in some sense, and I like to do things where it's like, wow, I didn't know that was there. And it shows you something about the world that you couldn't see otherwise.
Thanks to you for watching, and thanks to Bill, Serge, Vincent, Julian, Deidre, and everybody else who made this video possible. Like I mentioned before, a lot of the videos on this channel in some way touch upon computer vision, so I've put those all into a playlist, and I'm putting that in this video so that you can check that out if it so interests you. That's all from me for now, and I will see you again soon. Bye.